Happy Passover, Josh. All week. For those that are unfamiliar with Passover, what is it?
It's a celebration of the Jewish people's exodus from Egypt. It's also now apparently the Jewish exodus from Columbia University as pro-Hamas protesters terrorize Jews.
Yeah, it just...
It is.
It's insanity.
An update at 7 o'clock.
Yeah, Josh will have that. I'm not sure how the terrorist organization Hamas got this whole thing popped off, but death to Israel is being chanted. I need someone to make that connection. But happy Passover to you and yours, the good folks in the tribe.
Thank you so much.
You're next week traveling to see the sister. You actually have to stay in an entire other home because there's so many people.
Oh, God. Uh-huh. Yeah. They live in a, this is not in their normal home. They have a bungalow.
Sounds sexual. Well, I hate it because Mudge would tell me stories about when her dad was living on his own.
Yeah.
And he had like this little place and he was, you know, he was taking lady callers. Uh-huh. And he would invite them to what he called his bungalow.
I just wanted
to spray the wall and vomit just because he'd have like a kimono on. Coming into my bungalow, I just burned some incense.
So there are going to be 15 people there. And normally I would have stayed in the house with everything. But the family has grown by about 5 people in the last 2 years.
Damn.
So now I've been demoted. I have to stay in a neighboring bungalow. The people are not going to be there. But I've been assured by my sister it's going to be clean and very nice.
And it's your own spot, too.
Yeah.
So you don't got any kids running around,
jumping
on your crotch at 2 a.m.
No.
People playing loud music in the next room. It's kind of nice. I mean, I know you've been excommunicated from the family. Shame. Put him out in the menstruation shed.
Yeah.
But you get your own spot. That's kind of nice.
So I'm looking forward to I get to see I get to meet my new great nephew.
Okay.
Did you ask me yesterday his name on the air or off the air?
I know he asked. I can't remember where it was.
I don't know the name. By the way. I can't remember.
Well, you'll find it out.
But anyway, yeah.
So you have the dishes. You got the shank. You got the shank bone,
right?
The bitter herb.
Yeah.
You've got the bread. There's like 7 others that I can't remember. Is this also the one where you go around the table and you tell the story?
Yes, it's a nightmare.
Because, and you're a professional orator,
right? You go around the table, and if there are 15 people, I mean that's this week. I don't have to do that next week, but everybody has to tell their story, and the kids. They make little projects in school. They make their little booklets and pictures, and they're so small. They have to stand on the chairs.
Very cute.
Yeah, very cute. But after 20 minutes, you have to move on.
You're like, okay, come on. Let's get to the next part of this chapter.
That's
Our people
right.
have been through enough, either imposed on them or self-imposed. Well, Josh, here we sit in the middle of Passover.
Oh, this is our own Seder.
It is. This is ours. Teach us. Last week we had some fun with the Yiddish word of the day.
Yeah.
What was the big one last week? The hanger on, the barnacle, the sycophant. What was the big one?
The nudnik?
There was nudnik, but there was another one.
Chazer?
Chazer.
Okay. That's it.
Chazer was great. It's fun to say.
What is that book? What is that?
Well, I was perusing my library last night. Mm-hmm. What was I looking for? What the hell was I looking for? I don't remember, but I was... and then I noticed this. It was like divine intervention because I had forgotten I have to bring, you know, do this Yiddish thing today.
Take a guess how many books you have.
Oh.
In the thousands?
No. Maybe.
It's got to be over 1,000.
Oh, I have no idea.
One day I will find the book that I pull off the shelf that does make the shelf slide aside so I can go down into that chamber you think we don't know about. So what do we got there?
The book says it's called A Dictionary of Yiddish Slang and Idioms, a quick and easy phonetic guide to the basic words and phrases of the world's most colorful language, including curses, maxims, by Fred Kogos.
All right.
Okay.
Hit us with one. Give us the word. We'll try and guess the meaning.
Oh, this is a good one.
I like
brought
it
my
so
glasses.
Far.
Okay. Paskudnik. Paskudnik.
I got it. Is a person, place, or thing?
This is a person. This is a personality.
Okay. Give it to me one more time.
Paskudnik. Another way of pronouncing it. Some people pronounce it Paskudnyak. That's the way my father pronounced it.
Paskudnyak.
He'd call many people Paskudnyaks.
Scott, you want to take a crack at it?
I mean, it sounds very familiar. It just sounds kind of like someone that's an unbecoming and unsavory fellow.
Yeah, I'll co-sign. I was going to say pain in the ass.
Yeah, it's a nasty fellow, revolting, disgusting fellow, mean. Yeah.
Paskudnyak. It all sounds Russian.
Paskudnyak.
Okay, write that down. I'll be using that later on today. Give us another.
All right, I'm still on P. Potch.
Potch.
P-A-T-S-H. Potch.
Potch.
I got nothing.
Can we have it in a sentence?
I'm going to give you a potch.
Damn it. a potch, a compliment.
No, it's actually the opposite.
Oh, they're insulting
you. Okay, if you don't behave yourself, you're going to get a potch.
Oh, like a
punishment.
Spanking.
Yeah, it's kind of like a slap on the face.
Oh, you're going to get like potch as in like punch?
It's more, it's a little less than that, slap, smack on the cheek.
Okay, well, love tap right on the mush for being out of line.
We don't like to go too far.
Yeah, got to wonder if there's any nice words in this thing. All right.
Let's see here.
Fast forward.
I'm going raw. Raw as it comes.
Yeah, bareback us with a little Yiddish.
Okay,
You know, Joe tried to find gefilte fish yesterday to bring in, and he couldn't find any.
Yep.
Yeah. How many places did you go to?
One.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah. They don't have it at the Exxon.
Oh, that's a good one. Happiness is nachas.
Nachas?
Yeah.
Not this.
If you're proud of someone. It's usually used am I boring you? Is this not?
I'm fascinated with Jewish culture.
Okay. All right.
Because I'm terrible at my own.
Okay. The nachas is like, if your child is getting married, I'm shepping nachas.
If there is a way for me to be a part as an invisible entity at your visit to your sister's house, I would give up my vacation just to go and hang out as some specter in the corner.
I'd love to see if I know it would never happen. But a picture, like, of the house and the neighborhood and the bungalow.
All the stuff.
Of the bungalow? I can take a picture of the bungalow.
Could you do a little...
I just don't know what... I don't know what that neighborhood looks like.
I wouldn't post it, but...
Take the pictures and show us when you get back.
Okay.
I know you wouldn't trust us to put them on social. I will post them
immediately. It's in Queens, right?
Well, we're going to be in...
Are you going upstate?
Yeah.
Oh. That makes more sense. I was trying to figure out, like, what this place... So you're going to be at the, like, the cabin vibe, like, in the Catskills.
Yeah.
Oh, that's fun.
I want to see the full Norman Rockwell, everybody around the table. I want you doing the bit, like all those zilches on stage at the award show where Ellen DeGeneres and Bradley Cooper was taking a photo.
Yeah.
I want that with the entire crew. I want to put some faces to these legendary names. We've seen a few throughout the history, but you speak of, for a man that's as solitary as you are, to then be thrust into this South by Southwest of Jewish relatives, where you're running around doing the Seder, eating bitter herbs. I just want to see some photos. Enjoy your week off next week. You have 2 days to go.
All right. You've already seen pictures of my sisters.
Yeah, I just like seeing them, like, all together.
Yeah, they're off limits.
Okay. Come on, give me the number.
I'll get pictures of my nieces and nephews.